April. My name is Christy Robinette, and this is your February 2021 forecast. This month is all about playing. It is time for you to stop stressing and to play more. Sounds so good and so easy, but it's so not, because the last year you have felt inundated with responsibilities. I mean, we're in a pandemic, so I get that. But this month is looking at how you can infuse play into your daily life. Not just schedule it for a week in a year or a weekend a month. It is every day. What can you do to learn to play more? So it can be as whatever is making you feel that your heart is being cared for. It can be coloring in a coloring book. It can be going for a walk. It can be taking a longer shower. You've been beating yourself up a lot this past couple months. And this month is, let's not beat us up, Libra. Let's not do that. And instead, let's find some playtime. One of my favorite practices is to take a deck of oracle cards and... doesn't matter what kind, you can feel drawn intuitively which way or the other, and to shuffle them and ask guides and angels and whomever wants to give you a message as to what you should focus on. It makes for a really good journaling prompts if you don't know what you're supposed to be journaling about, or it can just be a focus for that month or that week. This month, I chose a deck called Soul Truths, and the card that dropped for you, Libra, was this one. Does my life have room for more pleasure and play? Pretty apropos, right? So it reads on the back, in what areas are you lacking pleasure right now? Maybe in certain relationships or with work? Is it possible to shift the seriousness of life to experiencing a more creative, wild, and playful side of you? I think that there is sometimes a stigma with work and play can't go together, and that's not truthful at all. If anything, it's a healthy balance that helps both. So the action is, what would happen if you added more play and laughter into your life? What area is lacking this right now? Take time to play, let go of any need to produce anything. I one time went to a lecture with this lady who did laughing yoga. Have you guys ever? So what she did was, in the yoga, you had to laugh while you were doing the poses. And you're forcing that laugh, right? You're forcing that breathing, that huh, 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 you know, while you're laughing. But what was so funny was, have you ever been in a room where someone told a joke and you didn't really think it was funny, but one person started laughing and their laughter was contagious and you started laughing, and then by the end of it, you had no idea what you were even laughing about? That was how this yoga, this laughter yoga was, this laughing yoga. It was ridiculous, and even it makes me want to laugh to think about it. So it might be like, it's not supposed to be forced play and it's not supposed to be forced laughter. However, you might have to start it off that way. Put a comedy on. Tell a joke. Learn improv. Take a class online. Do something that might be out of your comfort zone, but still brings play to your world. I believe in you, Libra. Have a great month.